Good morning, all of you. This is Muralishan, BCom student from Faculty of Allied Health Sciences, University of Jaffna. Today, I am here to present my research on dispensing practice at hospital pharmacies in Jaffna district. Dispensing practice, assessing the dispensing practice is necessary since the patient arriving in the health sectors with the set of symptoms and the compliance and with the care, expectation of the care they will receive from the health sectors. Typically, in case this is the healthcare professional pharmacist responsibility to give them optimum care even at a high workload pressure. The labeling requirements and dispensing time may vary country to country. Low dispensing time may support to manage overcrowding but lacks in patient care. In 1990, WHO elaborated with INRUD and developed some guidelines to assess dispensing practice in health sector. Based on that, the average dispensing time was 90 seconds and the labeling requirements was at least the label should contain drug's name, patient name, dose and frequency. Based on the WHO guidelines, the dispensing practice was assessed. This was a descriptive cross-sectional study which was conducted selected three hospitals in Jaffna district. A population proportionate systematic random sampling was used to study the 600 patients and the 10 pharmacists. Interview type questionnaires were used to assess the patient as well as self-administered questionnaires for the pharmacist. When it comes to the results, among the 600 dispensing, 15%, only 76 dispensing were more than 90 seconds. Others were less than 90 seconds. And nearly half of the dispensing, 299 dispensing were between 31 to 60 seconds. Among that, 4 dispensing were less than 10 seconds, which seems even the basic information were not given to the patient during those dispensing. And average dispensing time was 56 seconds. When we see the each health facilities, 47, 55, and 78 seconds in each health facility. And teenagers and old age patients spend more time in dispensing counters. They need to be advised more regarding their treatment, so they spend more time in dispensing counters. As well as patient educated less than O level had more adequate dispensing time. They are less educated, so they need to be more educated regarding their dosage schedule, so they spend more time in pharmacy counter. As well as permanent pharmacists and the pharmacists attending less than 200 patients per day spend more time in dispensing. This seems the pharmacists spending more time when they are and the optimum dispensing practice. When we come to the labeling, the drugs among the 1,713 labels, drugs name was noted in 72% of the label, and dose was 96%, frequency was 95%, and none of the labels have patient's name. Patient's name is very much important in order to avoid the mixing of the drugs among housemates. Even the housemates are getting the patient name in each and every label, it should be considered seriously. Apart from the WHO guidelines, there are some national guidelines to labeling. Based on that, strength was written in 34% of the labels, and before or after meals was notated in 39% of the labels. Before meals was mostly written, but the missing was after meals, that much not considered. Hospital's name was written in 24% of the label. So according to that, the adequate labeling percentage was zero. But if we exclude the patient name, 69% of the labels had name of the drug, dose, and frequency. Apart from the legal guidelines, there are some professional requirements fulfilled in the label, which means the frequency should be written in words, not in numbers. If we written in numbers, they may confuse with the dose and frequency. So based on that, 90.1% of the frequency was written in words, as well as 9.9% in numbers. Then the male pharmacist pharmacist aged between 21 to 40, graduate pharmacist, experienced pharmacist between 10 to 20 years of experience had more number of adequate labeling than others, as well as the pharmacist attending less than 200 patients per day and the pharmacist working less than 8 hours per day had more number of adequate labeling than others, which seems the labeling will be more fulfilled when the pharmacist workload is reduced, as well as dispensing time was negatively correlated with labeling fulfillment. When we conclude the research, the dispensing time and labeling were fairly satisfied, and that not that much far from WHO guidelines. Since there are something to improve, and the pharmacist workload should be strictly reduced. Thank you.